I demand to have some booze.
For more than 35 years, we've all basked in the majesty of Richard E. Grant, beginning with his debut in the cult hit With Nail and I.
I'm starving. I can make it die.
Since then, Richard's been an acting chameleon, from leaning into his dark side in the Star Wars universe...
Yes, Supreme Leader.
...to managing the Spice Girls on screen.
I think I may have just started the breakup of the Spice Girls.
His career culminated in an Oscar nomination...
I'm thrilled.
...thanks to a starring role alongside Melissa McCarthy.
Quite by accident, I find myself in a rather criminal position.
What criminal activity could possibly involve it, except a crime of fashion, of course?
Richard was recently struck by the tragic loss of his wife, who set him a challenge to find happiness every day.
The pleasure of being in the garden, surrounded by all the things that we planted together. Grateful for the 38 years we had together.
Now, he's bringing her lessons to our shores in his show, An Evening with Richard E. Grant. A night I'm sure will be real E-great. See what I did there?
Incredible.
Could you please welcome to the project the great Richard E. Grant? Welcome, Richard. Lovely to have you here. Happiness. What's making you happy today?
Well, obviously talking to you four. I couldn't be happier having woken up at 5 a.m. to talk to you.
But this is an extraordinary request from your late wife. Quite a legacy, I imagine, it's left in your life. And it's one thing to look for happiness every day, but it's another to turn that into a show. How did you go about doing that?
I was commissioned to write a memoir at the beginning of the year because I'd posted a video clip on social media saying that just before my wife had died, a year ago, she had said, "I know you're going to be sad, but... I charge you to try and find a pocket full of happiness in each day." And at the time, it seemed such an impossible thing, you know, navigating the tsunami of grief that we suffered. And it so seemed to resonate with people, this phrase, that I've written a memoir, which is coming out in Australia at the beginning of October. So that's the reason I'm coming to Australia, to do a tour and a one-man, you know, show where first half I will talk about, you know, my 38-year marriage to Joan and all the ups and downs of show business life and, you know, everything that happened in between, trying not to be too indiscreet, and then taking questions and answers, you know, questions from the audience and hopefully being able to answer them.
You know how you were saying that it was kind of Joan's gift or edict that she left with you?
Yeah.
But mired in grief, when you start trying to find happiness, how did you start that? Like, where did you start?
Every single morning I've woken up and, you know, I've said to my daughter as well, what are we going to try and find in today? Even if it's a simple thing as, you know, just walking around looking where you are, or speaking to a friend, or taking a walk along the river, just... to find joy in something and to hold on to that rather than be mired in the obvious negativity that you suffer at the beginning, where it seems like you're never, ever going to get out of this trough of grief.
I'm sorry to hear that. I mean, I often think about the idea that we're all on this pursuit of happiness, but sometimes in this desperate pursuit of happiness, we miss the happy moments that there are in each day because we're just striving for more and more and more.
Exactly. So, you know, I was so riveted to read about the late, great Olivia Newton-John and how she remains so extraordinarily positive and upbeat despite, you know, having to cope with breast cancer for, you know, 3 decades, which is, you know, an unbelievable amount of time. But, you know, the tributes that have flowed in for her are so life-enhancing that... you know, I'm always encouraged by that.
Your career is so eclectic, Richard, from Star Wars to Downton Abbey and many, many more in between. How do you pick and choose what roles resonate with you?
Well, usually when somebody's turned something down and they say, well, who else can we get that's not going to cost us an arm and a leg? Oh, we'll get him. I have no idea. You know, I've been around for so long that I think, you know, my wife said to me, you're in the sort of condimentary years of your life. You'd Dijon mustard or a hot English mustard. You're sort of brought in for sort of add a bit of flavour to the cooking pot.
Well, I'm not sure if anyone knocked back the role in Loki that you played. You were so good. And I'm wondering, in this outfit, we could almost see your pocket full of happiness there, Richard. It was a great outfit. Was that a fun time?
Thank you for bringing up this humiliation on national TV in the early evening. You know, viewer warning required. You know, I thought this is my one chance to be in a muscle suit. As you can see, I was born without any. So I begged the costume designer because I said it was exactly like the original cartoon. You know, I have big muscles and a V-shape and all of that. And then I was put in the sort of panto, you know, Lycra Kermit outfit. But, you know...
Hey, Spice World is celebrating, which I cannot believe this, 25 years next year. As their manager, yes. Will you be appearing in the next Spice World incarnation?
Well, I know it was made before you were born, so I'm surprised that you're even talking about it. But they haven't called me yet, so they may use a holograph or... I have no idea.
I don't believe they haven't been in touch because we have evidence. You've been hanging out with Ginger Spice. There you go. This is publicly available information.
Yeah, and she has invited me to her 50th birthday party, which, you know, birthday was last week, but she's having a big bash in September.
So what happened after that photo? How many karaoke sessions of Wannabe did you get involved in?
None, but she's having my twins next month.
Wow.
That's a bigger scoop than the one I was going for.
You know what? You should have remembered to wear a condiment. Sorry. I'm really sorry.
Yes, it's on. It's on, yeah. Thank you. Lower the tone.
It has been an absolute pleasure having you on tonight. If you want to go see An Evening with Richard E. Grant, awesome. Go to our website. All the details are there. Richard, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much indeed. Thanks a lot.